Hello and welcome. So I am doing another video out of seasons and I'm using my Neocolor 2s for the background and I'm going to just apply them directly to the page and I'm going to go ahead and go right over top of this little frame that Hannah had drawn in. Later on I will be outlining it with a white Posca pen and possibly using some kind of sparkles and maybe my white Prismacolor pencil. I'm not exactly sure. I need to work that out. But in the meantime, we'll go ahead and just cover it with the Neocolor 2s. And so I'm starting with Prussian blue. And then I will work in lighter blues towards the center of the page, and then we'll be using Prismacolors, my favorite pencils, for the rest of the page. So let me know if you have any questions or comments and I will get back to you. Also, per usual, I will be popping in and out with voiceovers explaining as I go along. All right, so as I get closer to the main image with my Neocolor 2s here, I'm not going right up to the image because I, you know, don't want to cover it up with the Neo 2s. So I'm getting pretty close. And then what I'll do is when I use my brush and water to activate, then I'll just push the color into those little tight spaces. Also, if it needs a little bit more of the pigment, sometimes what I like to do also is pull the color with my paintbrush right off of the crayon itself. You'll see once we get to that point, I think I have some footage of me doing that. So it's a technique that I do quite a bit, so if you've seen my videos before, you'll have seen me do that in past videos. But just keep watching and you'll see what I mean. All right, so here I got out a few brushes. I got out two different sizes of water brushes and my favorite size 10 round watercolor paintbrush. And that's actually what I ended up using for this whole page, is my watercolor paintbrush there. I like to use the watercolor paintbrush, especially when I'm doing big areas such as this. Just makes it go a lot quicker, and I really like the blendability it has for those neo colors. Just makes it look really nice, in my opinion anyway. And because it's got kind of a pointed end on it, I can get into really tight spaces with it as well. It's really a versatile brush. It's one that I just picked up at my local Hobby Lobby art supply store. It was one of their their house brands. So it wasn't very expensive. I want to say it was probably between $7 or $10. But you can just use whatever brush you prefer. I mean, obviously, always do what you prefer to do. But just for those who want to know what I am using, that's what I'm using. And I'm just going to activate these darker colors around the outside of the page. And then I clean off my brush and I go in and start with the lighter colors, and I kind of push it into those dark colors just so I can keep those light colors light and don't muddy up that, you know, that light blue in the center there. Okay, so here's where I grab my Neo 2 with that light blue, the turquoise blue color, and because I realized I needed a little bit more of that pigment, I grab it straight from the Neo 2 crayon and apply it with my paintbrush. All right, so coloring in these flowers here, I'm going to do two of them on camera. So what I'm doing is coloring in the darkest parts with the raspberry. It's my darkest color on these flowers. And really, there's no real rhyme or reason. I'm just kind of following along where I would think shadows are or would be for these flower petals with that raspberry. And then I will use my pink, will be the next color that I use, and just kind of throw that in over top of the raspberry and extend it out a little bit. And still leaving some gaps because I'm going to come in with my salmon pink, kind of an orangish pinkish color, and add that in some spots just to vary up the color a little bit. It just adds a really nice effect to the flowers. So yeah, I made a little bit of a boo-boo. You can see that I think it's supposed to be a leaf behind where I'm currently coloring. I started coloring it red, but it's actually going to be green. So I kind of erased it. So I just didn't want you thinking that I was coloring those as part of the petals when they're actually going to be leaves. So yeah, here's where I'm going in with that pink and just, you know, extending out that raspberry color and still, like I said, just trying to leave some gaps and some room to throw in that salmon pink and some uncolored areas where when I go in to blend with the white pencil, that will act as highlights. Okay, so I pulled out this Winsor & Newton white ink, and I am attempting to cover up those lines that Hannah had drawn right there in the center. I really do not want to mess with all of that detail work, so I'm just trying my best to kind of cover up. I know it doesn't get completely covered up, but it works just fine for what I'm going to end up doing. I'm just using kind of an old cheap paintbrush there, not one of my nicer ones, because I didn't want to risk ruining a nice watercolor brush. So I'm just kind of whiting out that center there, and then I'm going to go back in with my black Prisma pencil and just kind of create my own feathers following the top lines and kind of connecting them down to the bottom lines. So once that ink has dried, I'm just kind of creating my own feathers there following some of the line work that Hannah had made, and just kind of honestly going by the seat of my pants here, not really sure how this is gonna work out, and kind of crossing my fingers really. But I know I'm going to be adding a lot of white Posca details in these feathers, so that always helps with how the picture looks overall in the end. Okay, so I just wanted to pop in here a little bit and go over what I am doing for this border. I don't know if you can see, hopefully you can see the glitter that I put in there. So what I am doing is I'm gonna go ahead and use my white Posca to outline this frame border. And then I am going in with this. I've got this Folk Art Extreme Glitter acrylic paint. And as you can see, it's just basically a shiny, clear glitter. And I decided to use this instead of like my Wink of Stella or a glitter gel pen, just because there's a lot here to do and I thought it would be easier and also wouldn't use up my pen because I have a lot of this. Wouldn't use up all the ink in one of those pens. And you know, I just wanted to give this stuff a try. I bought it a long time ago and I don't know. Well, I must have used it once, but yeah, I've hardly used it at all. So what I did was I just poured a little bit in the palette. Now you can see here it looks like it's white, and it does kind of go on white, but it dries clear. And I just applied it with my size 2 watercolor paintbrush. So I will go over some of this. I'll show you some of this on camera, kind of fast forward so you can see how it's done. And then I'll do the rest of the frame off camera. All right, so I decided I didn't like the just the white Posca on his eye. So I brought out my black glaze jelly roll, and I'm just going to kind of create a little, eye there with the jelly roll, because it kind of creates a little bit of a raised effect. And then once that dries, I will go ahead and just put a tiny bit of my white Posca in it for a little bit of eye shine. And since I still had a little bit of that glitter acrylic paint in my palette and wanted to use up as much of it as I could, I went ahead and added some of it to the center of these little sparkles throughout the page. And so this wraps it up for today's video. I hope that you've enjoyed it. Let me know if you have any questions or comments down below. And don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. And we'll see you in the next video.